Hello, this is Tony Heller from RealClimateScience.com. Voltaire said, "Those who can make you believe absurdities can make you commit atrocities." Here's an example from wildlife presenter Chris Packham.
It's time to make up my own mind and decide if I think it's time to break the law.
What are we going to do about it? An overwhelming number of people recognize that we are in danger. They fear for their own lives, children, frightened for the future of life on Earth. No government, no major political party has ever significantly addressed the issue. They haven't been listening to us, the climate activists.
Now, I'm not asking for anyone to break the law. There are so many lawful ways to get involved.
Raise your voice. Post a poster, sign a petition, paint a banner, go on a march, lobby your local MP.
However, for me, myself,
we're in significant and obvious danger. But I've got to raise my voice. If you're an activist that's already made a decision that, yes, you're going to break the law, so long as no one is hurt and there's no lasting environmental damage, then you'll have my support. And personally, I think I've reached a point where I now consider it the ethically responsible thing to do.
I responded to him on Twitter. If you actually believe what you say, you should go to China and act on your beliefs, because they burn more coal than the rest of the world combined. But I'm guessing you won't do that. The reality is that the rest of the world could drop off the map, and emissions would continue to increase because they are skyrocketing in Asia, particularly in China. If you believe that carbon dioxide emissions are destroying the planet, you have to get China to stop doing what they're doing. Emissions have been declining in North America and Europe for decades. It should be obvious that if you want to reduce CO2 emissions, you have to get China to stop building new coal-fired power plants. What I was saying was pretty obvious, but I got some fascinating responses. I got a lot of responses like this. Per capita, which is key, China doesn't, and their green energy production outperforms too. Be careful of how the data are read. I'm pretty sure that climate models don't consider per capita emissions. If you want to reduce carbon dioxide levels in the atmosphere, you have to get China to stop building new coal-fired power plants. As I mentioned previously, North America and Europe could drop off the map, and the amount of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere would continue to increase because of what China's doing. These responses show that people are pushing an anti-West agenda, which has nothing to do with climate. And here's a similar article from Reuters. China's building two-thirds of the coal-fired electricity generation capacity currently under construction globally, and this may not be as disastrous for the climate as it sounds. So according to Reuters, huge amounts of carbon dioxide from China are not disastrous, but much smaller amounts from the West are. 9 years ago, Barack Obama and Joe Biden made a deal with China. This was the headline from The Guardian. U.S. and China strike deal on carbon cuts in push for a global climate change pact. But the actual deal with China was that they would continue to increase their CO2 emissions until the year 2030. So it wasn't a deal for China to reduce emissions, rather the deal Obama made was for them to increase their emissions. And now China's emissions exceed all developed nations combined. Which takes me back to Donald Trump's tweet from November 6, 2012. The concept of global warming was created by and for the Chinese in order to make U.S. manufacturing non-competitive. The name of this video is Some Carbon is More Equal, which is a reference to George Orwell's novel Animal Farm. This is how Google AI explains the phrase. All animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others, is a quote from George Orwell's novel Animal Farm. The quote appears in capital letters on the barn door, where the seven commandments the animals were told to obey once appeared. The quote is a comment on the hypocrisy of governments that proclaim equality for all citizens, but give power and privileges to a small elite. A good example of that occurred yesterday at Versailles, where Marie Antoinette lived during the 18th century. The elite got together to discuss how to get the peasants to reduce their carbon emissions. Steve Malloy explained what was going on. After jetting from the UK to Paris to call for emissions cuts, Charles jets from Paris to Bordeaux to call for emissions cuts. All carbon is equal, but some carbon is more equal than others. Perhaps Charles should say, "Let them eat green energy." Charles seems to be unaware that the UK's fake climate goals are bankrupting the country. Toto has been pulling back the curtain on the climate scam for more than 15 years. You can visit him, Kyrie, Caesar, Toki Upla, and the four new puppies on the web at realclimatescience.com.